Hello there, human! So today, from my spaceship, I'm going to show you guys, or talk to you guys a little bit about basic maintenance and commands that I think would be useful for new Linux users, or, you know, just casual Linux users and stuff like that. I will not go into Arch, Linux from scratch, Gentoo and all of that, because that's kind of not the demographic for this video, because they require a little bit more hands-on approach than, let's say, Ubuntu, Pop OS, Mint, Elementary OS and stuff like that. And I am using Pop OS right now, as you guys can see here. I just themed it and stuff like that. So maintenance for Ubuntu / Pop OS, Debian and stuff like that, there is kind of not really anything compared to Arch Linux. Where in Arch Linux, you have to be careful of your cache folders and stuff like that. Ubuntu, Debian, and those kind of distributions, they kind of do that for you. You don't get, you know, your hard disk magically just disappearing because it has cached, you know, the last 600,000 updates that you've done and stuff like that, which can be a good thing if you want to reverse back packages and stuff like that. Ubuntu, Debian and stuff like that, they tend to not do it. They tend to auto-clean it. The only command that I use, let's say, once in a while, once a week, every 2 weeks, once a month, kind of depends a little bit on my mood, is the sudo apt auto-remove. What this does, it's removing packages that are installed but no longer needed. So if I go in here and I press in my password, there's none. There's actually one that needs to be upgraded. I do recommend that updating and upgrading Ubuntu derivatives, Pop OS, Mint, and all of these distributions from the terminal instead of using their software, because it gives you a little bit more information on what's going on. So sudo apt update basically just refreshes your repositories. It's like, hey, is there anything new in the repositories? Do we need to repopulate some cache files regarding the repositories and stuff like that? And it also tells you if there's anything that needs to be upgraded. And then you just do sudo apt upgrade to basically upgrade your system. This is also when it tells you if there's anything that can be auto-removed, meaning that there are packages that's left over from uninstalling, installing, modifying some packages on your system. So these are kind of the three commands that you kind of need to know to maintain Debian, Ubuntu, derivatives, and stuff like that. It's actually really, really simple. It does a lot of the maintenance behind the scenes compared to Arch Linux, where you have to do a lot of the maintenance manually. So let's take it from here. Sudo apt update. Let's look at the, you know, let's refresh the repositories, make sure they're all up to date, that we can actually connect to the repositories and stuff like that. Upgrade if there's anything to upgrade, and once in a while do auto remove. That's kind of all there is with maintenance within Ubuntu, Debian and stuff like that. You don't have to think much about cache folder, temp folders and stuff like that. Actually, the Linux gurus and the people that know Linux, they recommend that you don't delete your temp folder, because Linux do that every time you reboot anyway. So it's only if your system is up and running for like a month that you may need to go in and delete your temp folder. But so far, these are what you need. Three commands: sudo apt update, sudo apt upgrade, sudo apt auto remove. That's all. That's the basic maintenance that you need to be aware of on your Linux system, meaning Debian, Ubuntu, derivatives and stuff like that, which is the biggest install base in the world, you know, like Mint, Elementary OS, Sorbian. All of these distributions utilize this here, Pop OS, if I didn't say that. What about some basic commands to just get you, you know, familiar a little bit with the terminal, which is the one that we're in right now. One I like to use a lot, which is not really a command that you need to know, but it's a good command, in my opinion, to know to just get rid of junk, and it's clear. And it basically just clears your whole screen. So you don't have, you know, past commands that you have to look at and stuff like that. So if we do stuff like this here, I actually managed to put in df command here. So if we don't want to look at this and we want to free up more space, we just put in clear. It's just a little, you know, it's clearing the screen, so to speak. I would say that the biggest or the most useful command for a new user in Linux that wants to go into the terminal is how to navigate the terminal. So we can use a command called pw or wd, depending on where you are in the world, which basically means print working directory. So it tells you where you are. So now I'm in /home/test, which is my home folder. And then you just use the cd command or change directory to do a lot of things, and you can do a lot of with it. If I want to go into a folder, I need to see what folder's in there with the cd command. So you can do ls to see what's in there. And this basically lists, so to speak. I don't know if that's what it stands for, but I also associate ls with listing. Again, it shows you what folders you have. So I kind of want to go into downloads. Well, change directory to downloads. And you can use tab to autocomplete. So now we are in downloads, and we can again list what's in there. And we have a changed TDM background master, which is a script that I'm trying out to change the TDM background and stuff like that. Not for this video. What if I want to go back? Well, we could do it in multiple ways. Like in Linux, there are thousands of ways of changing or scaling a cat. So you could change directory and then use the whole path. So we want to go back to where we was before home test, as you guys can see up here. And right now, if I print my working directory, we are in home test downloads. So you could do cd /home/test, and we will get into cd home test. So let's try this one out. Let's print the working directory. We are in test. But let's go back to downloads again. See, we are in downloads again. There's an easier way. Change the directory and then just use two dots. It's basically, think of it a little bit as using backspace on your browser. You know, you go back to the previous page. So now we are in pvd, print working directory. We are in home test. So if I do this again, right, I'm in home. Those are like the basic navigational commands that you need to understand. So if you don't know where you are, pvd to print your working directory. If you want to see what's in the directory you're in right now, you can use ls. If you want to change to some directory, you use cd and then the path to the directory. So we want to go into etc. So we are in etc, and we can list what's in etc, and there's a lot of stuff in here. So now our screen is cluttered. Do that, and then if you want to go back a directory, we can use cd dot dot, and we can list that again. Now we are here again. Not so much to say, but this is like basic of understanding the terminal. How do I basically navigate around the terminal? Then you can do a lot of things. You can edit files, you can, you know, change permission and all of that stuff, which can be a little bit more complicated or a little bit more advanced. Like, first, I think it's really, really important that you learn, you know, just how to navigate the terminal. You know, how do I get from one folder to another in the terminal? If you want a little bit of information, so I can't spell. There you go. If you want a little bit information about your system, there's a couple of ways of doing that. A lot of people are using something called HTOP. You may need to install this yourself. I kind of like HTOP. Press F10 to do that. You can also use TOP, and TOP is mostly installed by default on a lot of systems, and you press Q to stop that one. Again, give you processes running, free memory and swap and stuff like that. So let's clear this one up here. If you want to see, you know, just your hard disk space and stuff like that, you can use a df-h command. And it's basically just for human readable, this h, to make it a little bit more readable. Give you a little bit overlay about what your disk space is and what's, you know, mounted and what's not mounted. So you can see up here in /DEV/SDA1. We have a total of 43 gigabytes. We are using 9.5. We have available 31, and we have used 24%. So if you compare this without the DAS heads, you can see here now it's looking really, really crazy. Basically, what this does here is, I think this is bytes it's showing it in. And here it just, you know, use megabytes and gigabytes and stuff like that. That's the only difference. So that's some really, really great commands also. So if you clear this one here, so top, press Q to get out of it. Htop, press F10 to get out of it. You may need to install that. And the df-h command. Give you basic information about your system. You may also want to know what your kernel is. And there's different ways of doing that. You can do uname. You just get the name of the kernel. You can also do uname-a, give a little bit more information. Uname-r, just the version number of the kernel. I just got a brain fart there. I typically just use this one here. We get the Linux kernel, we get the distribution, we get the kernel number, generic, and then we get, you know, the revision number. And we get when it was, you know, made and what's, you know, it's a 42-bit system. So I kind of like that one. Sometimes I also use this one if I'm only interested in the kernel. For sake of easiness, I will just do A-A. Again, navigating in the terminal, getting a little bit information about your system. You know, the kernel, processes running and stuff like that. And that's kind of like the basics. You can also use top and htop to kill, you know, rogue system processes and stuff like that. The same with htop. Htop is by far the easiest one to use. I will recommend that you use htop if you want to experiment with this here. I don't want to show you guys how to kill processes. It's kind of self-explanatory. If you look at like F1 to 10, it kind of says like F9 to kill something. So let's say I have like a program running that is not responding. You can go in here and kill it with that one by using your arrow keys up and down as I'm doing here. And then be like, oh, Firefox is not doing its thing. So we can actually open up Firefox here. Yoink. Here we have Firefox here. So you can say like, oh, this is not doing what it should do, so we can press F9 and it should kill some Firefox. Oh, here, send, we need to signal kill signal there, number 9. There you go. So I pressed F9 and then I used, you know, out in the side menu, I used the number 9. Command. That's S signal kill, I think it was like SIGKILL or something like that. You can go in and do that here with the htop and top. Again, I do recommend using htop in the beginning because, but it looks nicer. I use htop all the time. It's just way nicer than top, and it's a little bit, you know, you can use your arrow key here to do a lot of crazy things. So it's a neat little program to mess around with. What else do you may want to do? I don't want you to go crazy in the terminal. Like, the next thing could be opening and editing a file. So let's see, where are we? We're in the root directory. So let's go into our home folder. So we use cd /home/test, and that would put us into our test folder. So we have nothing there. So let's just create a file, and I'll just create a file in via the file manager here, so you guys can kind of see virtually what I'm doing here. So we don't want a new folder, we want a new file. So let's open edits. So here you can see I'm making a new file. I want to save it. It's saved in my home folder, and I will call it test.txt. So that's basically a text file. Save it. So it contains this here, and as you guys can see, it's down here. So if we list in here again, you can see now we have the test text file here. One of the easiest, and still not that easy, but one of the easiest text editors in the terminal is Nano. And a lot of people are like, oh, you should use VM or Emacs. Use Nano, okay? Even eMac and VM fanatics, they use Nano if they are just going to do a simple little modification to a file. So if you want to alter a file in Linux, you know, like a config file in via the terminal, Nano is really, really great at doing that. So if it's a file where you need root permissions, you need to put sudo nano and then the file. Because we are the owner of this file, we just made it, we can just do nano test.txt. I just use tab here to autocomplete. So if I click enter, I'm in here right now. And as you guys can see, it's this text file right here. So now we can... No, my bad. So now we can do all kind of things. We can add to it here. I'm just doing a lot of things. So there's a lot of things down here. What this little up arrow here means, you can see here, where is replace, you know, write out read file. So it's like up arrow, that's control. If you want to save this file, you kind of have to write out the file. It's a little bit confusing. It's not save, but it's write out. So basically what you're doing is you're holding down control and you're pressing O. So now it tells us, do you want... What file name do you want to save it in? So we can type in a new file name. We could call this one, test one. So we can do this, save file under different name. No. Oh, sorry, save file under different name. Well, we just changed the name, so of course we want to do that. Boink. So we should have two files there. We have the original one. And we have the one we just made. So how do we exit Nano? Quite easy. We look down here. This little up thingy here, which means control X, and now we out. So if we list again, we have two files. So let's do nano test1.txt. So now we should get the one we just altered. So let's remove a lot of stuff here. La 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 la. We want to save that one again. Control O, write out. We want to just keep the file name. Press enter. It's now saved. We want to exit. Control exit. We have now have the opportunity to modify files in Linux. Again, if the file needs you to be a super user or root, you need to do sudo in front of it. So if you're going into the etc folder, for example, and you want to alter some files in there, you need to be sudo or super user, or you need to be root, so to speak. So therefore, you use sudo, nano, and then the name of the text file. If you are not in the folder path of the text file, so if you're not in the same folder where the text file is, you need to do the whole path. So if we go back one level, so you guys can see right here, we are at in home, the home folder. Well, the test.txt file is in test. It sounds a little bit crazy, but if we want to basically modify this file here, we now have to do nano. Oh, it actually helped if I'm in here. nano /test/test.txt. Directory test does not exist. Did I do something wrong here? Oh. There you go. We didn't need the forward slash. You can see what I mean about this. So now we can edit this file here. So we can just put a lot of number ones in front of it here. Control O, enter, Control X. So if we go into the test file, we have now a lot of ones. So I will say this is kind of the basic you need to know to maintain your Ubuntu Debian system or Ubuntu-based system. And to do like simple tasks in the terminal, you know, basic commands, you know, get a little bit information about your system, navigate, you know, the directories in your system, you know, navigate, go into a directory, go out of a directory and stuff like that, and edit a file. Those are the things you're going to do the most. You can also copy files and move files and stuff like that. New people will more than likely use this here to copy paste files, basically. Another really, really great tool, this is a bonus, and this is Midnight Commander. You may need to install this. Look at this as a file manager in the terminal. if you want to move stuff around and stuff like that, it's so much easier with Midnight Commander. So over here you have a directory you could go into. So look at this as one file manager, and over here you have another file manager. So if I want to move something into downloads, for example, I have this one here. I go over here, I go into test, I go into, do I have anything in pictures? I have. So I want to move this picture into my downloads folder. So I can help menu, view, edit, copy, move, make directory, stuff like that. So I just want to copy it over. So that will be F5. Press F5. And I just go down to press OK. Now the file is in there. Going to downloads, we have the picture in here. This is way more convenient than going to do all of these move commands and stuff like that. If you go F10 to exit that one also. So I recommend that you install Midnight Commander. And again, if you want to move files around where you need root permission, you just do sudo Midnight Commander. There you go. And now you have basically a file manager in your... I use this a lot to move themes and icons around. Can you use the CP and the MV command? CP is copy file and the MV is move a file. And yes, however, I kind of just like you to use Midnight Commander. It's way easier to get your head around. It's way more convenient to get your head around. It makes a little bit more sense when you're just starting out. Moving files with the CP or the MV command, or copying files with the CP command, there's a lot of flags you can add to it, so do different things and stuff like that. In here, you get a graphical representation of what you kinda are doing. So this kinda, in my opinion, is the way to go. And trust me, I've been using Linux for 25 years or so. I use this all the time. I don't want to go in and put CP or MV and then a path to one file and a path to another file. It's way easy to basically just go in. So, oh, I just downloaded something and I want that in my user share backgrounds folder, for example. So I just put it in there. This is way easier. So I can just go in here and then do that. We can't do that right now because we need to be root to do so. So if we go in here and do that, see, I don't have permissions to do it. So we need to run Midnight Commander as a super user via sudo, but you get the idea here. I hope this was a little bit basic for you, and I hope for you guys, and I hope this was a little bit like to get your feet wet in the terminal. Is there anything else you guys want to know about these? Like, I want to know more about the CP command or the MV command, because we could make like an hour video just about those commands. Where these commands right here, the ls command, pwd or pwp command, the clear command, you know, the top htop command, the nano command, you know, to edit a file. They're kind of like, they can't be really, really, really technical. But the way that I just showed you guys it right now, this is how most of us use these commands. See you all later. Bye bye.